So, Dr. Ren Alvarez.
Gracias, gracias, Mayra. It's a placer de colaborar juntos. And I would say that we have much more work to do. We have a great future together. I'm president of Xavier University of Louisiana, and as you may know, we were founded to educate the sons and daughters of people who were not supposed to be educated, sons and daughters of slaves. And also, the person who founded us, Sister Catherine Drexel, Mother Catherine Drexel, committed herself to educating Native Americans and blacks, and all the other, those others who need the education. And that has been the reason for her existence. I would like you to remember that, to tell you that even in the 1930s and 40s, when technically it was illegal in the state of Louisiana that blacks and whites would go to school together, there were white students at Xavier who were studying here. We could not give them degrees, but there's a little school in Philadelphia that would award them their degree. I'll leave that off the books. And therefore, we've been welcoming students of all ethnicities, origin to Xavier because we achieved some great things. I would tell you that we are, among African Americans, the school that produces more students who go on to get medical degrees of any school in the country. That may be a good thing, but it's not a good thing because there are other schools that are 10 times our size that should achieve that as well. But we have been doing this for decades. We send more of them to doctoral degrees. And I would say for any student, black, white, Asian, Latino, Hispanic, who comes to Xavier, their chance of getting to their dream is greater than many schools that I respect. For example, if I speak of Swarthmore, if you come to Swarthmore, no disparagement of Swarthmore, and come to Xavier, it's a great school, but you would still, your chance of achieving your dream at Xavier is greater. We've done that for many years. It is not that. We produce lawyers, several judges who are on the federal bench, and judges who are everywhere. We produce artists, and we welcome every student. One of the things I would say is that at Xavier, we do not welcome just students who are at the top of their educational achievement. We bring students who do not have the education that they deserve coming to us. Because understand, we know that every young person in this country does not get the education she or he deserves, and children do not choose their schools. But what we have done since our origins has been to fix the gaps that students come to us and to send them off at great capacity. For example, if I recommend to you to read a small book which is now circulating throughout Amazon and other places called The Pulse of Perseverance, where three young men, younger than I, they're in their 40s, they're not that young, who are doctors who show how they came through and how they were, recognize how, well, how ill-prepared they were and how Xavier was there to cover them and bring them forward. We've been welcoming, for example, the sons and daughters of the Vietnamese boat people who came here in the 80s. And they are at Xavier learning. And now we've always been ready and welcome to welcome Hispanic students who come to us from many different states. In fact, what we have realized, how many of our students, especially those from the Northeast, have one Puerto Rican parent here, a black parent from Harlem or from Brooklyn, that Hispanic dad has been coming to us for many, many years at Xavier. And we've been working closely because we believe that no talent should be uncultivated. One of the things that we have seen, that we know about ourselves, is that we've been transforming lives in bringing people and the economic capacity of our students. For example, a recent study that was done comparing all colleges in this country who bring students from their lower two-fifths of the socioeconomic ladder, their families, into the upper three-fifths. The top 10 schools in the country were named. Xavier was sixth. It included also Baruch College in New York City and a few others. But sadly to say, the only school in the top 10 in the Southeast was Xavier. So it is and our work continues that we want to actually address this equity issue because we've always been doing that. And every student here who needs an education should be able to access the highest reaches of education that would develop his or her talents. And we do that at Xavier, and we are committed to working with you and with students coming out of all the K-12 schools to make that happen. One of the things that we are doing with the K-12 schools is to prepare 900 well-prepared teachers for this region, because only a good teacher makes a difference. It begins with a good teacher and not with all the other structures are helping that teacher. So we are making that happen. So we're committed to work that, and we would see that every child who comes here would come in the future, would be able to be a major member of this economy wherever they go to college. Thank you.